Question number one on screen, circle with center O, angle BOC 30 degrees, this is BOC, and AOB 60 degrees, and you need to find ADC, this one. So 60 and 30 together make an angle 90 degrees here first. So AOC is the angle subtended by AC, the arc AC here at the center, and that AOC is equal to AOB plus BOC, 60 plus 30, 90 degrees. And ADC is the angle subtended by the same arc AC at the remaining part of at D. D is on the remaining part of the circle. AC is the angle subtended by arc AC in the remaining part of the circle. You see, I am changing the position of D, but still the measure of the angle is same. You can, AC can subtend angle ADC, that D can be anywhere in the remaining part of the circle, then it will be like this. So same angle, anywhere it will have the same angle. So angle 2, ADC is half of angle AOC. Angle subtended by an arc at the center is double the angle subtended by it at any point in the remaining part of the circle. That is what is the theorem we learned, theorem 10.8. Using that theorem, ADC is now half of angle AOC, that is half of 90 degrees, 45 degrees. A circle with center O, PQ is a chord, okay, equal to the radius of the circle, and it is subtending an angle POQ at the center, right? You can understand that. You need to find the angle subtended by the chord, or you can say PQ arc also, there is no problem, at of course in the major arc and in the minor arc. In the major arc, the angle subtended by PQ is PAQ. In the minor arc, the angle subtended is PBQ. Therefore, let us see the first part. Here the chord PQ is equal to radius. Therefore, in triangle POQ, OQ is equal to PQ. That means all the three sides of triangle POQ are equal. So each angle is 60 degrees, and the reflex angle POQ will be 360 minus 60. Reflex POQ is equal to 300 degrees. This you have to keep in mind first. And angle subtended by the chord PQ in the major arc is PAQ, in the minor arc is PBQ. Then, next one. Therefore, PAQ is directly half of POQ, that is half of 60 degrees, that is 30 degrees. So whatever is the angle here is double the angle here. That means this angle is half of this angle. That is understood. Now, for this one, PBQ, this is the angle in the minor arc, that is half of reflex angle POQ, that is half of 300 degrees, it is 150 degrees here. Okay? And you can verify the angles now like this. See the verification? 60 degrees and 30 degrees. You may tell, will it happen that this 30 degrees, will the same is the angle anywhere? Yes, it is 30 degrees anywhere in the remaining part of the circle. In the remaining part means in this major arc only. Okay, I am putting only in the major arc, right? Here the same is the angle in the minor arc. Here also it is 150, here also 150, here also 150, anywhere it is 150. Okay, that can be understood. Now, that is what is the second problem. The third problem is already on the screen. Are you all there, children? Are you all there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what?
Yes, sir.
For your benefit.
Yes, sir.
Today. Okay. 2 days over. So many would have forgotten those what happened in the previous class. That's why I'm revising. I don't know. The same thing may happen on the Monday also. Let us see. All right. Here we go to the next one. Question is, in this figure, PQR, angle PQR is 100 degrees, where PQR are points on the circle with center O. Center O is the center of the circle here. PQR are simply points. What type of points, we don't know. Okay, definitely it is understood that PQ is not a diameter, because it is making 100 degrees angle here, it is not passing through O. Now we have to find OPR. That is the question here. Then solution. Here PR is a major arc. PR is a major arc. Therefore, reflex angle POR is equal to 2 times of PQR. 2 times of PQR, this angle. That means POR, actually what is POR? Well, let us understand. POR is equal to, now reflex angle POR, or simply POR will say, POR is equal to, reflex POR is equal to 2 times of PQR, that is 200 degrees. Therefore, POR is equal to this 160, you have to subtract from 360 to get this POR, normal angle POR. So that is 160 degrees. Now, let us compare the angles in triangle POR. In this, one of the angles POR is 160 degrees and OP is equal to OR, they are radii of the same circle. Therefore, angles opposite to them are equal. OPR is equal to ORP, angles opposite to equal sides of the triangle. Therefore, OPR plus ORP plus POR is equal to 180 degrees. So 2 times of OPR plus 160 is equal to 180. So 2 times of OPR is equal to 180 minus 160, that is 20 degrees. So 2 times of OPR is 20, OPR is equal to, now it is 10 degrees. Now we can verify this fact by an experiment, by actual measurement. You can see this is 160 degrees angle. This is 160 degrees, it is understood. And here these angles are 10 degrees. This angle is 10 degrees. Okay. Now this is the third question. Question 4 here. Let us see the question. In this figure, you need to find ABDC, where angle ABC is given 69 degrees, angle ACB is given 31 degrees. Let's concentrate on triangle ABC first. And this one also, of course, we'll see that later. What can you talk about angle BAC and angle BDC? They are the same angles in the same segment. Angles subtended by arc BC at two different places, at two different points on the remaining part of the circle. That means they are equal. Whatever is the angle here is the angle here by theorem 10.8. Angles in the same segment are equal. Therefore, this angle is equal to this angle, we know. But how to find this angle BAC? Very simple. BAC plus this is equal to 180 degrees by angle sum property. Therefore, BAC is equal to 69 plus 31, 180 minus 100, that is 80 degrees. Angle BDC is equal to 80 degrees. Therefore, BAC and BDC, they are each is equal to 80 degrees. You can see by measurement. And if I change this point here, I change here, and even here, anywhere you can take this BD, it is equal to ABC. Okay. This is the lesson here. Now we can stop here for today. Thank you.